Right, bye field for another year. Not as pretty as last year. It's a bit spoilt with the gates. Don't know. Field looked a bit untidy. There's a copse, there's a trig point right over there. But there's no designated pathway to that trig point. I don't think you're really encouraged to go over there. I have been over there, of course. I just felt a little bit of a chilly breeze then. So I've cooled off a bit. I've had a drink of water. I've just got a nice sweet to suck going down this hill. Red knoll in front of me. I've seen me loads of times. I mean, I used to do a lot of cycling a few years back, all across the levels. And I used to see Brent Knoll when I was right over the other side, miles away near Glastonbury. And gradually, I would, on the way back, I would be near it, and then it would fade away again as I went towards Weston. Yeah, breezy, tide must be coming in. See, I've been sheltered for ages. I'll be down in the valley again in a minute. There's the copse. And I just noticed a load of crows. Oh, there could be rooks. They're all sat in a field, hundreds of them. And they're flying about up there. Yeah, in a minute I'll be down in the orchard valley. A lot of people growing cider apples around here because they can flog them up the road to Thatcher's. Thatcher's have expanded massively over the last 5 years. Absolutely massively. They almost own Sanford. They, you know, it's just everything to do with cider there. And these farmers down here, they're growing apples because they've got a market up the road. I should be going right down into that valley, not far from the river. Yeah, I've walked down here when it's been baking hot. Usually walking down here when it's baking hot. I think it's colder this year. Overall, I think it's been colder. March and April have been colder than last year. Definitely. I can tell from my videos. But it's warming up again now I'm out of the breezer. It's a big secluded house here. It's got brilliant views across the levels there. They've usually got a couple of Dobermans in the garden that follow me by the path. I mean, they haven't got out yet. Do you know, I really can't understand what the stiles and fencing around here. It's as if someone's been smashing them up. They were used to be so strict with their gateways. And this one's all damaged as well. Weird, isn't it? It's all private, see all that? It's all private. All the woods around here are private. Things haven't changed that much. Well, they have. They've changed quite a lot, I think, since Henry VIII, but Richard III. It could be that someone's got their offices out here as well. That's what often happens now. They have a barn, they convert it into an office. Yeah, I think I came down here one Easter and there was, the family were all sat out eating, drinking their wine. Big flash cars in the drive. Like we'd all have if we had the money, I suppose. Yeah. I've had it, lost it. But at least I had it something once. And it's been in the family in the past. Wealth. Absolute wealth. It's in the tree. Paupers, peasants, and princes and kings, said Bob Dylan to Woody Guthrie. Hey, Woody Guthrie, I wrote you a song. But the funny old world that's coming along. It's sick and it's hungry, it's tired and it's torn. And it looks like it's a dying, it's hardly been born. Yes, I know that song. It's a real folk club song, that was when I was growing up. When I was a teenager. That's something going on the A38 now, huh? Or no, it could be, not the A38, that 371, I think it's called. That they got their big camper van. Hillfield Farm, that's called. It's a lovely view, though, look, with Brent Knoll in the distance, look. And the valley, all the orchards, all those fields down there are orchards. They're growing the apples for thatchers. So what's happening? Fertile lands in a, on the river plain. And further over, we got some shining in the distance is a river axe. Of course, that. I'm not actually going that close to the river today. And there's a house. A house on the hill. I expect they see me, if it's the same people, so it's that woman again. It'd be interesting to compare my different videos over the years. Obviously the cameras have improved. Not that I'm any better at handling them though. Do you know what I mean? You could have a Rolls Royce and a Mini. And it's the Rolls Royce won't drive any better if you can't handle it. Yeah, there's just something nice about this. Look how green and fertile looking it all is. That lovely house there, look. How nice to be able to live somewhere like that. Private, with room. Yeah, I can see somebody walking right over in the distance. Because there is a walkway over by the donkey field over there. There's different ways to get into Bleadon. I'm doing like a what I call my traditional route. It is longer really. But it's got to be done. I mean, like I say, I probably do it again, but that's when I'm on a short walk. Today this was the big one really from Winscombe. But of course in the past I've walked from Weston to Wells in the day. It took 9 hours. I've done Wells to Cheddar in about 7 hours. And it's not going like on a straight road, you're up and down, round and round. But as you can see, I am selecting routes. Now it's cow season, the season of the cow. I'm selecting walks now that are cow-free. Nearly. There could be a risk further up. I've got one field to cross. And I don't really know if the cows are going to be in it or not. And there's not really a... I think I can walk around them before going through the gate. There is another way. I know I had to use it once before because I didn't want to go in with them. I skirted around the edge where the barbed wire was. Well, so anyway, I'll face that when we get to it. I know that this particular farm had changed. Didn't seem to be having cows where I'm going to go now. But used to, and then it stopped having them. But I could get down there today. This is a year later, look. And they've got them again. Yeah, not brilliant video, I'm afraid. I'm not very good. But it's for posterity, especially if we have a nuclear war. I don't expect anything to be saved anyway, will it? What with all things being stirred up with... Oh, look, there is a stile there. I suppose I've noticed it before. Not sure I have. Yeah, probably have, but I got a feeling there were cows and I had to turn back. Yes, that's right, I had to turn back from there. I got in a field over there, there was a load of cows. Yeah, big steep climb, isn't it? Nice place to live though. But you see, the nice place to live, I like my flat. I've got a nice Victorian flat, right? And, you know, it's nice. I'm near a park, which is a pleasant park as well. And they have like a band playing on Sundays. Not that I go and watch it, but they have pop groups and all sorts of people playing in there as well. They've got a little cafe in there. It's Jill Dando's Memorial Gardens in there. And then I've got everything at my fingertips where I live. I can... If I get a bit of cabin fever, I can just go out and walk round Weston. Within 10 seconds, I can be in town. I've got the banks, the post office, the council offices, the beach. I've got bus service, coach service, train service. You know, it's all at my fingertips. So that's good. I've got good neighbours, really. I don't know much about their lives. We don't really interfere with each other. They're not their neighbours from hell, put it that way. This is pretty, isn't it? I expect some of you are falling asleep now. This is quite a long video. But of course, like I've said to you, I can always split it. That's the thing with this battery charger, I can just leave the video running. It's such a nice area to video as I'm going along, I think, with all the bluebells out. And like I said, I only usually do this once or twice a year, this route. I could have cut short my route back to Weston in lots of ways, you know. If I hadn't decided to go up that big pathway earlier at Loxton, I could have just nipped over up the road and got straight to Bleadon in a quarter of the time. But that isn't the aim. It's not a race and it's not about time. Like I said, this is a bigger route. And it seems a long time since I was on the strawberry line earlier this morning. And I was on the bus, of course. There's no bus. There could be a bus at uphill. There could be a bus. I might get a bus if there is one around. They don't pack up at 6. I don't really know what they do, buses, actually. but once I get to Uphill, it is quite a hike back to where I live, really. It's all the way along the seafront. And I've got to stop and get some food for dinner. I'll be soaking my feet tonight in a bowl of water. There, and we come around this corner, look, and look at that view as you come around that corner. And there's all the apple trees in those fields there. That's all little orchards, and they've gradually expanded those fields over the years. They've got a market. They've got Thatcher's up the road. I've been in there, believe it or not. I came out of there once. Their gates aren't always shut. I'm glad that they weren't shut that day, because I'm always worried about big dogs. That's it. So you've got to be careful if you accidentally go on private land, because somebody might have dogs running free. Right, over and out.